The story I had last week about the coverage of the Ethiopian airline crash has an interesting follow-up, which is that the Washington Post wrote an article called "Ethiopian Airlines Had a MAX 8 Simulator, but Pilot on Doomed Flight Didn't Receive Any Training." And the Ethiopian Airlines dispute this story and write that all the allegations in the article are false defamations without any evidence, collected from unknown and unreliable sources meant to divert attention from the global grounding of the B737 MAX airplanes. So, in particular, they see the fault not with their pilot but with the airplanes themselves, which have been globally grounded, and there seems to be increasing evidence that indeed these airplanes are not very safe. Ethiopian Airlines further states that Ethiopian airline pilots completed the Boeing recommended training before they start flying the B737-8 MAX. And Ethiopian Airlines has 7 full flight simulators to train its pilots and other airlines pilots. It has one of the largest and most modern aviation academies with training devices and technologies among the very few in the world. The airline invested more than $500 million in infrastructure only in the last 5 years, which is not common in a typical airline. So, we will probably find out the truth once the investigation in the plane crash is completed. And, well, up to then, we don't even have to make any judgments in this case. If the truth is that the airplane itself is at fault, then the Washington Post has grossly misinformed its readership. If not, maybe it has still misinformed its readership about the training procedures of the Ethiopian airline, but we will at least find out whether or not the airplanes themselves are to blame. What's interesting to note here is that the Boeing 373 MAX, which was the type of plane that crashed, became Boeing's top-selling aircraft, and that Boeing made the safety features in this airplane an optional extra for which it charges additional costs. And an expert asked by the New York Times, which is Bjorn Ferm, an analyst at aviation consultancy company Lehem, states that safety features are critical and cost almost nothing for the airlines to install. Boeing charges for them because it can, but they're vital for safety. So, at least this much seems clear that once again we have just not enough regulations here. Because if Boeing can charge for them, then it will charge for them, which is just the nature of capitalism. If we want Boeing to have safety features installed in the airplanes that it sells and not have to let the airline companies decide whether or not they need safety features, which a lot of them might say no to because they again are companies and are interested in profit maximization, then we need regulations that tell Boeing that it can't do that. So, yeah, once again, capitalism fails. Or in this case, it's just the regulation of capitalism. But of course, we have such a lack of regulations because the companies use the money to influence governments in order to not have these regulations, which would cost them more money.